Exercise 9. In this exercise, we're going to take a look at the functionality in VIA-CAD 2D 3D version 8 with regards to prepping it for a mold. We're going to make a cavity of this part, and then we're going to go ahead and bring it into MasterCAM and create a toolpath. So before we do that, though, this is going to be a cast part, and it's going to be the split is going to be in the center here, and pretty much where the parting this parting line is going to be essentially where this grid is located in the center. So what we need to do is add some draft, and draft is usually required whenever you're going to pull something out of a mold. And best example, if you're not sure what draft is if you look at an ice cube tray, like the old ice cube trays where you fill them with water and you put them in the freezer, notice there's like a taper or an angle that's on the sides of each ice cube. That's put in there intentionally so that it could pull out of the mold or out of the ice cube tray. If it was just flat on the sides, it'd be very difficult to remove that out there. So that's probably the best analogy I could think of. Now what we're going to do is we're going to start by, I'm going to go to the work plane here and go to my front. Just so happens to be near the base here. I'm going to go to, I've already extended out these a little bit, these ends, and there's a neat tool in here for that. In this version 8, there's push-pull. You just click on a face, and you just grab it, and you can see you can drag out a specific distance. So that's all I did. I actually just dragged it out a little bit. So when I add the draft, it doesn't cut away or remove too much material from the part. Undo that. So you could do that pretty easily with that tool. It's pretty darn cool how that works. Anyhow, so I'm going to go to my view and go to the front. So I'm looking at the bottom here. Remove any holes. Unless you need those holes, that's fine. You could leave them in, I guess. But in this case, I had holes I had to take out. And now I'm just going to take the line tool and make sure I snap to the grid. And I'm going to line. Just want to make sure I can get that origin and draw a line across here. Let's try that again. Just wake up the center. That might be a little harder than I thought originally. I'll just draw from the center. Click. Not my center there. Fortunately, okay, now just with some sort of line that you have like that, that's fine. Now I'm going to go ahead and go over here to this tool, Project, Curve Surface. You'll notice Control to embed into surface, and then select the curves to project onto surface. So hold Control while you select this curve, and then select one of the surfaces. And then now you have to select 2 points for a projection vector. So in this case, I'm going to go to the center and just turn off my grid here so I could go along the Z. Okay, unfortunately in this case it didn't quite take. It only took one side. So you want to make sure it goes all the way through. I'm going to undo that. I'm going to go ahead and drag out this line. You can click on it on the end. Drag it out further. Okay. Now we should be able to do that. And it didn't take last time, so we'll make sure we do this right. Okay, Control, select the curve, and then select the surface. And then 2 points. There we go. Ooh, rat. It unfortunately added it around the part. It didn't add it in the backside, so I just have to make sure I go in the other direction. So let's do that one more time. Control select the line. Select the surface. And the same thing with the vector. We just actually drag it out along the Z. apparently didn't hold control. Let's try that one more time. Control select. Control select that. And we just won't let go of control this time. There we go. You have to hold control the whole process so you get that line across there. Okay, in the meantime, I'm going to hide this line. Don't delete it because I believe it is needed. I'm going to work plane and go back to global. Alright, you can see the split face there. So with that now, I could go ahead and go and find the draft tool, which is right over here. Draft face. We only want about, we're going to put 2 degrees of draft on this. Okay, and so we're going to hit enter. Select the reference face or edge face to draft. So I'm going to go ahead and I want to select top here. It gives me a reference. And now select the faces that I want to add the draft to. Select this face here. And now I'm going to go ahead and specify the neutral position, which is this endpoint here. It doesn't move, it doesn't change. And now it might be somewhat hard to see here. And in fact, I think I'll change this to something like something that you can see. I'll change it to 10. And there, now you can see the draft. Change it back to 2. All right, let's do that again. This time I'm going to hold shift. Want multiple faces. Go to the draft tool, select a reference face, and the face solid to draft. So I'm going to shift here. Actually, that I only need that one, I suppose. Start over there. Okay, select the reference face. Face to add draft 2, and then the neutral position, this corner. There we go. And now I'm going to go ahead and add it on the bottom side. This one I should be able to do both at the same time. Shift. So again, select the reference face. I'll flip it over to this side. Select this face. Select the faces to draft, holding shift, select both this one, this one over here. Actually, let's go and select this one too. Alright. Now you know I did neglect to select the one on the inside there too, so let's go ahead and get that one. Again, select the face. For the reference, select the actual face we want to add draft to. Neutral position. Okay, I don't know if you can see it or not. If we go to turn the work plane off, and go to view, go to the left side. Actually, it looks like the draft is in the wrong direction. Or I guess maybe I didn't add it over there. Looks like it's there. Let's go to the right side. Nope, apparently I missed it. Okay, let's try that again. Actually, I'm going to click on this and see if I can find the draft of the features here. Okay, just make sure you add the draft. What we're going to do next is we're going to go ahead and add our mold or crater mold. Work plane, show grid, and I'm going to go ahead and draw a rectangle on here to grid. Okay, and I could specify length and width. pretty good, actually. All right, now I'm going to go ahead and extrude that up. I didn't want mid-plane just yet. Actually, just distance. Let's delete that for a second. Try that one more time. Select chain by right-clicking. There we go. Asymmetric. Okay, it's on the backside. Not a problem. Okay, now just change color to something a little bit more. Well, I can see a little bit better here. Go with that gray. Now I'm going to just use the subtract tool and control to retain the subtracted part. So first select the solid to subtract from, and then the actual solid of the part that you want to subtract. And what I usually like to do here is go to the layers and add a new layer. We'll call it the mold, the cavity. Cavity 1. I could click on that part and we could just go over here to find layer, put it on cavity. There we go. Now we can edit the cavity and hide the solid. There's our cavity. At this point, I want to export it out, but let me put some rounds on because it's going to be inserted into a bigger mold base here. So put some rounds, corners. Now we just select it, go to File, and Export. And I would recommend exporting it STEP or iGEST. STEP is probably one of the best. Although, bringing it into MasterCam, you could bring it, send it out as an ASUS SAT file. But you might want to bump it down just to like version 20, because sometimes they're off by a couple digits there when it comes to whatever version of SurfCam you're using, or a MasterCam, and then select it only. That will prevent all the other parts from coming along with it. Hit OK. And we go to solve the image and clamp. Just drop it on desktop. Okay. At that point, and start up MasterCam here. Okay, and we're going to import that part. So just go to Open. Under MasterCam Files here, find the ASUS SAT, or ASUS, there it is, kernel, desktop. There. I think that's it. No, it's this one. There we go. Let's shade it. Okay. Now it is upside down currently, so we're going to have to go ahead and flip that around. So just go to Transform, or Xform as it's called. Go to Dynamic Xform. Select the geometry, hit enter, pick a position, click, and then find those little arrows that appear. And once you get this little dial, when you move over them, like the Z, you go ahead and just flip it. If you want the Z to be on top, make sure it goes to 90. You can type in the value up at the top there, it says minus 180. But in this case, we're in good shape, because I got it. And then hit enter. The green check. Turned it to like a pinkish color. I believe it's just to let you know that's translated. So we could just go to shade settings, select color, pick a different color. All right. Now at this point, I'm going to go to mill. I'm just going to use the default for this. Obviously, you'd want to pick your post, correct post. Go to stock setup. All solids, then go to tool setting, go to select down here for material, and select from the library. And we'll go with 6061. Actually, in this case, you really wouldn't want aluminum. It should probably be a steel. Anyhow, that's all right. This is just to show you how to use this. Okay, at that point, now that we have this ready, we could go ahead and start adding toolpaths. So, go to toolpath, and I played around a little bit with this, so I'm not an expert by any means. There's lots of guys out there much better, probably send me little messages saying, you know, you should have tried this or that. Anyhow, I'm still learning, so what I'm going to go here with the surface finish rough, I'm going to go to pocket, check mark there, check. And then select the surfaces, just click and drag a fence surrounding everything. Hit enter. Found 44 surfaces, hit the green check. Now we get to go to our tool library. Now this is not a huge part, so I have to go with something small, and I'll probably go with a ball end because it's a radial pocket inside there. So I could probably get by to rough it out pretty quick, maybe with a half inch ball just to get a lot of that out of there. Check mark. Now you have some surface parameters you can change if you want. Go to high speed. And hit the green check. Alright. Now let's just verify that. Let's go over here to the verify. Play it. Okay. So we roughed it out there. I'm going to hit the green check here. Now we'll go and we'll add a little bit better finishing cut, maybe. Again, not an expert on this, but go to surface finish and we'll go with leftover. Check. Again, select the geometry as a whole. Enter. Check. And this time I'm going to go with a smaller end mill. Go with a quarter inch ball. And you can adjust your surface parameters. Check. Let it run through for a while. Let's run it. Okay, and then obviously you could go down to smaller tools and continue to improve upon that. Let's see, I'll go with one more here. And actually, I'm going to try with the radial. And I'm going to go with, let's see. A little bit smaller, maybe. I'll go with a 3/16. Now let's go 5/32. Get those little details in there. Let's give it a shot. Click on the top. Play. Help with the cavity a bit, but I think obviously I would work with someone who knows a little bit more about this process here. In terms of just a quick showing of some of the functionality in here, that's about all this is. So anyway, so that pretty much concludes this exercise.